Hey everybody, welcome back to Black Arrow Gaming. I'm Bob, and this is episode 10 in my Skyrim Ultimate Survival Challenge. In the last episode, I didn't do so good, I guess. In the top of Bleak Falls Barrow, way down in the final chamber, ran into a Draugr archer that I just could not kill under any circumstances. He was very powerful, he was one hit killing me, and my arrows were doing no damage to him. Because of the amount of damage he was doing, there's no way I have the option of getting up close to him, so I've decided to walk away. I'm going to be looking for some other options to take him out, and I've thought of a few ideas. One is a heavy armor approach, but I don't know if I want to invest the perk in that just yet. Another option is looking for a flaming bow, or some sort of bow with a fire enchantment, which could do quite a bit of damage. The fire spells seem to work very well. Problem is, I don't really know where to get such a bow or such an enchantment, and it'd probably be very expensive. The third option is to just level up, or look for other things to do for the time being. And I think I liked one of the options that one of the commenters on YouTube suggested, which I really appreciated, just said, why don't you try joining a guild? And I actually did that at one point. I tried to join a guild. Didn't work out so well, because that was the Thieves Guild, and the guy in the Riften sewers kind of chopped me in the face with an axe after having shot me with an arrow. Last I knew, he had been chasing me out that door, and I was afraid he would be right there when I came back in. But now that I have a decent block skill and a shield, I could hopefully go in ready to block his attack. I was handling those Draugr pretty well. He was wearing light armor, so I feel like I could take him out alright, as long as he's not hitting me with an arrow. So I think that's probably what I'm going to do. I'm going to start making my way towards Riften. I have a little bit of sorting out my inventory. I've picked up a lot of stuff recently, so I need to sort out my inventory between the different barrels and chests that I have things sitting in. Once I've got that done, I'll make my way over to Riften, try to join the Thieves Guild again, and possibly even look into becoming a Thane and getting a house out there. I was thinking it'd be nice to have somewhere to store all my stuff. Yeah, it's a pretty lousy day out here in Whiterun Hold. That's alright, because I'm out of here. I have all my stuff, or just about everything that I own, packed into this barrel. I'm going to take it all and just kind of drag myself over to the little cart and let him do the rest of the work for me. Get to Riften, I'll have to find somewhere to store all my stuff. I do have about 5,500 gold saved up, which I think is pretty close to what you need to buy a house. So that's kind of encouraging. Hopefully it doesn't take me too long to get somewhere nice to store all my things.
I can take you to any of the hold. Where do you want to go?
And I don't think it's too expensive to get out there. It's 100 gold, so
climb and back and we'll be off.
Yeah, that's reasonable. Better than getting killed by bandits and bears and trolls and whatever else is along the path on my way out there. Especially anything that can outrun me. Alright. Alright, and here we are. This is Riften, and it's apparently the middle of the night. Sense in getting myself into any trouble out here right now. I need to find somewhere to put all my things down, and then I need to find somewhere to set up camp, preferably somewhere safe. I got a little tent set up. Got my stuff put away. I think I'm gonna be all right. But my character is very, very tired. So I'm going to get some rest, and then I'll probably have to figure out food and stuff in the morning. Alright, it's a rather chilly Riften morning, but I've set up camp, slept through the night. Character is pretty hungry, fairly tired, fairly cold. Not tired anymore, but hungry, thirsty, cold. Not really feeling so good, so I'm going to head into the city and try to get some of my basic needs taken care of. And then may head down into the Ratway again. There's probably a number of things I can do around here, so I'll just kind of have to see what happens. Alright, I've taken care of all my basic needs. And organized all my stuff, set up camp, and there's nothing left to do but walk through this door and hope I don't take an axe to the face. Hopefully this doesn't turn out really super embarrassing. I'm going to have my shield ready. I'm going to be sneaking just in case he's nearby but not looking. Okay. So, no bad guy. Which means he must have gone back to wherever he was. Guess it's been long enough. Now, if he's standing in the same spot he was before, he's going to be right around this corner. And if the bow he picked up from his friend that I killed didn't despawn, he might still have that. So I'm going to get my bow ready. My steel arrow's ready. Let me see here. See if I can peek around this corner just a bit.
Is someone there?
Uh-oh.
Ha! Found you!
Crap! Run!
What was that?
Whoa! He was on the other side! What the heck? Well, my armor did its job. That was embarrassing. But I have better armor and a little more health, so he's not quite so dangerous anymore. The other thing important here is that he charged me with a melee attack, which means he's probably not using arrows. I tipped somebody else off down there. I heard somebody else yelling, but I don't think they're anywhere near close enough to do anything. So I think I can go in with my axe fairly confidently. I took a hit in the back and it didn't seem to hurt too bad. With my shield ready, I might be able to just take this guy in melee combat. After my health regenerates a bit, of course. That was scary. I don't know what he was doing over there. I guess they changed spots where they hang out, or maybe me entering here earlier messed something up. Alright. Alright, let's give this another shot. I don't think there's any sense in sneaking now. Oh my gosh! Not fair! Gosh! Well, he went down pretty easy. He actually wasn't that tough, but holy crap! He did continue his attack. I didn't even have a chance to get my shield up. I just had to take that one. Alright. Well, I'm glad this guy's dead. He was a pain. Had an orc mace. Not bad. That's worth selling. Potion of exhaustion. Yeah, that'd be useful. I don't think any of this other stuff is necessarily that great. I guess the hide armor's worth selling. Alright, you loser. There's nobody else here. You are dead. You remain dead. Never have to worry about you again. There are some other nasty people in here, but I don't think any of them are quite as tough, and I'm pretty sure the rest of them are a bit easier to sneak up on. So I just have to be careful.
Someone there?
There is nobody else here. Oh, sneak levels. Awesome. Just gonna take it slow here, let my health come back up. There, he lost me. Alright, what do we got here? A little bit of money. Hopefully that guy's stepping on bear traps. Sounds like it. going to keep my shield raised until I know where somebody is. There's really no sense in having my bow drawn as I'm rounding corners when anything could come running around and get me. Okay. Speaking of bear traps, I need to watch out for the same. I'm assuming those would still be visible, because you can interact with them. I don't know about wires or anything like that. Those, maybe not so much. Some of this I'm going to have to do from memory, I think. Oh, yes, the point of no return. Once I go down in here, I'm stuck. There's no getting out until I go all the way through the dungeon. But I'm pretty sure I've got everything I need. So let's do this. Alright. Let's be very careful. For all I know, Requiem could have even added traps. Probably not, but you never know. Oh, okay, I can see tripwires. At least there's that. Let's go ahead and disable this. Maybe. Alright, cool. Wonder what that would have triggered. I don't even see anything else in here. Oh, wait, there it is. Dart traps, right there. If I remember correctly. There's a pair of gloves, which these are actually a unique item. I don't think you can find... Well, maybe not. Maybe they're not. They're a good item for mages, because it's one of the few, and possibly the only handheld item in the game, or the only item in the game that covers your hands, that you can enchant without it actually giving an armor bonus. And mages... Depending on how you're using your mage setup, if you want alteration magic, you probably don't want an armor rating at all. Okay, here he comes. Okay. Alright. Oh, you're really gonna just go with your fists. That's right, I forgot. Good plan. Smashing good plan. Good job. Okay. Yeah, unarmed strikes do an additional 10 damage. That was a terrible arrow shot, by the way. I just straight up apologize for that. That was awful. I panicked a little bit. Need to not do that so much. Oh, cooked beef. Yeah, I'll take your food. Don't need the ale, but what is this? Oh my... Oh, yes! Awesome! Ring of Rejuvenation. Stamina regenerates 30% faster. That is a great find. That is awesome. I'm going to put that on right away. Let's see here. In armor, I suppose. Yep. Oh, fantastic. That's going to help so much. I'm going to be wearing that item for a long time. Because I'm always having trouble keeping stamina up. And you desperately need that. Otherwise, you can't do anything. Garlic's not a very common ingredient, so I'll grab that. Always take the free gold. It's probably mostly just junk in here. Yeah, I'm gonna move on. Okay, so that's two people down, one of which was painfully easy, the other two of which were terrifyingly hard. I should be able to see the bear traps. Yep. He set off a few of them, but apparently they didn't hurt him, because I think he was at full health when he attacked me. Anything good here? No, just an alchemy table. Nothing else to it. Okay. I am just not very good at sneaking. Everybody is seeing me. Okay, I do know that there's a trap right there. If I can see trip wires, I should be able to deactivate it. Ooh, what is this? Potion of Rigidity. Even if I don't need it, probably fortifies health. Let's see here. Yeah. Health is increased by 100 points for 300 seconds. That actually might be helpful against that archer. I think I'll hang on to that. Might allow me to take an arrow and survive. In fact, I'll bet you it would. So yeah, I'll definitely hang on to that. See, that's the kind of stuff I need to be finding. Things that can help me take that jerk out. Okay. I know for a fact that there's supposed to be a tripwire here. And that thing is going to come swinging down. Okay. This is not even fair. Pretty sure they made that tripwire invisible. My other option is to just sprint up the stairs, which I think I'm going to do. Make sure I can. Yeah. Yeah, I'm going to have to just sprint up the stairs and hope that thing doesn't hit me. Or maybe trip it from the side and jump off. I'll try that. Nothing. Okay. Just go for it. See, now why would you make the tripwire invisible? It doesn't even give me a chance. Wait a second, you know what? Hang on a second. Yeah, there it is. Never mind. I apparently don't remember this dungeon as well as I thought I did. That's a pressure plate, which, surprisingly, I can actually see, now that I think of it. There is no tripwire there, there's a pressure plate, and if I had gone up the other side of the stairs, that'd have been perfectly fine. How about I remember that for next time? I think I saw a butterfly flying around in here somewhere. That'd be nice to grab. I am wondering what this weapon is. It's just an iron battle axe. Not really particularly useful for my character, I'm afraid. Also have no idea where that butterfly went, so I'm not gonna worry about it. Just keep on going. Oh, wait a second. I do want these. Because blue mountain flowers mean really nice potions. Okay. Oh, this room up here has somebody in it. I think. What is that? That's a dead body. Okay, I don't know what's coming up in here. Why is that person dead? How did you kill yourself? There's nothing else in here that could have killed you. I think this person is usually hostile. It's a Nordic war pick. That's worth enough gold to sell. Don't really have enough inventory space to carry it. I'm wondering if there's something else in here that killed her. Because I truly have no idea, unless you just drunk yourself to death here, how you managed to kill yourself. That is really strange. But yeah, apparently there's nobody else here. Alright, whatever. Now here I can activate the way out. Which I will probably go ahead and... I don't need to go back up and sell any stuff yet. What's this? You know, reading those gives me some points towards the next skill level. It doesn't give you a full level like it did in the old Skyrim. Yeah, that's an expert lock. I'm not getting through that. Books don't seem to give you a full level like they did in vanilla Skyrim, but they'll give you some experience at least.
I'm telling you, this one is different.
Is it possible?
We've all heard that one that before. Land,
the attack say it was a full shipment of furs.
It's time to face the
truth. You idiot. He said furs,
Mercer.
Not furs.
You're all part
it
of
was
a dying
damn logging caravan.
Things are changing.
Oh,
dying breed.
Well,
what do you call
you won't
that?
Mercenary rebellious, will you?
Well, well.
Color me impressed, lass. I wasn't certain I'd ever see you again. If you were expecting a palace, then maybe you're not cut out for this line of work. Our methods involve secrecy and discretion. Now, if you're done belly aching like a child, how about handling a few deadbeats for me?
So I'll go back up there, pester some of the merchants, get them to pay up, and earn my place in the Thieves Guild.
How could you possibly know about... Please, my family means too much to me. Don't hurt them. Very well. Here. Take this back to Brynjolf and tell him he'll have no more trouble from me.
Please, don't take the statue. It's the only thing of value I have left. Not Lady Dibella. No, please, I can't lose her. I get the message. Here, take your gold. I hope you choke on it.
Oh, no. You're the one for... Oh, there's no need... Oh, and look, I even have the payment I owed. Here, take it.
Alright, I pushed everybody around, got the money for the Thieves Guild, and should be able to become a full-fledged member now.
So, job's done, and you even
what
brought the gold.
What is wrong with your eye?
Best of all, you did it clean. I like that. Dumping bodies and keeping the guards quiet can be expensive.
That's creepy.
Well done. Here you go. I think you'll find these quite useful.
Yeah, Potion of Arcane Disruption, Rigidity, and Ably Aiming.
Judging from how well you've handled those shopkeepers, I'd say you've done more than simply prove yourself. That's the spirit. Larceny's in your blood. I think you'll do more than just fit in around here.
You claim this recruit possesses an aptitude for our line of work. So let her prove it. Golden Glow Estate is critically important to one of our largest clients. However, the owner has suddenly decided to take matters into his own hands and shut us out. He needs to be taught a lesson. Brynjolf will provide you with the details.
Mercer, aren't you forgetting something?
Since Brynjolf assures me you'll be nothing but a benefit to us, then you're in. Welcome to the Thieves Guild.
Welcome to the family, lass. I'm expecting you to make us a lot of coin, so don't disappoint me. You watch yourself on that island. Those mercenaries don't take prisoners.
Some decent stuff sitting around down here. Just in these guild chests. What is that? Oh my gosh. Okay, yeah, I'll take that and happily sell it. That's worth 529 gold. Illusion spells cost 12% less to cast. Well, I certainly don't care about that enchantment very much, but I will definitely take the money from that. Man, they got a lot of nice stuff lying around down here. Oh, sweet. Oh, yeah. An elf shield with an enchantment. Increases the amount of blockable damage by 20%. That could help against arrows. And speaking of arrows, arrows that are even better against the undead than my seeker arrows. 10 Justice R arrows. That is awesome. Potion of Featherweight, that I'll just sell, but my gosh, this is great. So I'm going to switch that out right away, because if I look at my apparel here, there it is, that should have a better armor rating than the Imperial Shield, and indeed it does. So that just became my go-to shield. Sweet. I have an Elven Shield now. With an enchantment. What else do you guys have down here? Nothing that great here, but I'll take the silver arrow. A little bit more money. A book that may or may not give me any skill points. Don't mind me. Oh yeah, that's their guild vault. Okay. Well, I'm gonna go sell some nice things. Oh yeah, and there's a secret way out. Of course. Secret entrance to the Thieves' Guild right underneath the chapel. Makes sense. So yeah, I'm gonna go sell off some of the stuff, and then I think I'm gonna go visit the Jarl. The next quest that I have is a fairly tough one. I gotta go out to Golden Glow Estates and burn down some beehives. And Golden Glow Estate is an island that sits out in a lake. Yeah, it's right out there. It's a decently tough mission, and probably a fairly dangerous one. I don't know that I'll do that for a while, but I know there's stuff I can do around town to gain favor with the Jarl and hopefully become a Thane, so I think I'm going to work on that for the moment. But yeah, I got stuff to sell first.
Look, I don't think I should say. I mean, they could kill me.
Come on, tell me.
It's not worth dying over. Okay, I'll tell you.
Intimidated her.
I get my skooma from Sarthas Idrin. He has some sort of a setup over the Riften warehouse. You can't get inside, though. They've kept that place locked up tight since the war began. I overheard Boldy say that only the Jarl carries the key to the warehouse. When I meet Sarthas there, he's usually waiting for me outside with his bodyguard.
I swear if I wasn't around, Elgrim would forget to eat his meals. How we make any coin at all is beyond me. In fact, I need to arrange for someone to pick up an ore sample for me in Shore's Stone. Now, goodness knows Elgrim won't lift a finger to do it. You would? Oh, that would be wonderful. Speak to Filnjar in Shore's Stone. He's got some sort of ore sample he wants us to identify, and was willing to pay us well for it. Be careful.
Yes, yes, goodbye.
The road to Shore's Stone could be dangerous.
Okay, just picked up a quest to deliver something to someone in Shore's Stone. So I'm gonna head out that way. Shore's Stone is down the road from Riften a little ways. Unfortunately, I believe there is a bandit camp in the way. Not just a bandit camp, more like a bandit fortress. Pretty sure I know how to sneak around them, so it shouldn't be an issue. Oh, there's that person again. So I'm going to help her out with her skooma problems here in town, but I'll do that a little later. For now, I'll head out to Shorestone, get this quest done, and I think there's another quest I may be able to do once I'm out there. Now, I do know that there are bears in this forest. I think they're further off in that direction than I would wander. I'm pretty sure I'm safe if I stick to this road. That is until I run into these bandits up here. I'm just gonna try to quietly sneak around. Hopefully they don't bother me. See them moving up there. Now what I've found is that to get around this fortress, all you really gotta do is hang left. There's a nice little shadowy area over here. The bandits don't seem to go after you. Just in case. The bandits don't seem to go after you unless you get too close. That person over there can see me, but he's just ignoring me and moving on. It is getting dark. Alright, we're here in Shorestone. Need to find Alvor. He's the guy I'm supposed to be delivering all this stuff to. Oh. No, that's Flinyar.
I trust you're not planning any trouble. What can I do for you, friend?
You?
I hope you haven't arrived here looking for work in the mine.
Let me finish this quest.
It's about time. I sent them a letter weeks ago. Ah, that Elgrim. He'd forget his own pants if his wife didn't help him dress. Here you go. Tell Half-Yorg that she can chip off whatever she thinks is a fair trade for their time.
Would you happen to be headed towards Darkwater Crossing? My parents live there. I usually make the journey to bring them gifts and to just say hello, but I haven't been well lately. I've written some letters and placed them in a satchel. Perhaps you wouldn't mind delivering it to them on my behalf? You would? Well then, I would insist on rewarding you for your time. Here, take my satchel and give it to my father, Werner. He'll likely have something for you to bring back. I had a bad fall in the mine when I was bringing some food to the men. I was pretty bad off for a while. But a priest of Mara was passing through on his way to Dawnstar and healed me to the best of his abilities. I'm still pretty sore and I can't really walk too far without having to rest for a while. Darkwater Crossing is a difficult journey. Mind yourself.
Hey, it's another quest. But it's like pitch black. I don't know if I want to head to Darkwater Crossing. Darkwater Crossing is down a cliff in that direction that you can't even see. This is ridiculous. It's pretty cool, but... yeah, I can't see a thing. I think I need to get back to my campsite. I'll take the ore back over there and, I'm gonna take the ore back over to my campsite and probably rest the night, turn that in, and finish that quest. But I cannot see anything out here. There we go, that's a little better. And super creepy. Feel like something in these woods is just gonna jump out at me. But as far as I know, sticking to the road is safe, so... there we go. It's a little better. Although... what the... oh, I think it was a deer out there. Heard a noise. Scared me to death.
Thank you. I'll be sure to get Elgrim to examine this as soon as his busy schedule allows. Here, I had him make you a few things for all that travel.
Ably conjuring, ably berserking, ably sneaking.
Don't forget us aiming. If you need supplies for your journey.
You here for lessons?
Like, sell most of
those
right
back
to you.
So you're an alchemist then.
I don't need a potion of ably berserking, that's for sure. Or conjuring. Sneaking and aiming might be useful. There's Shadra.
Any luck with Sapphire? 5, 8! You actually talked her into it? I don't know what to say. I didn't think anyone in Riften even cared what happened to me. Look, I was saving this, but I wanted you to have it. I thought I might need it if Sapphire came for me, but I don't need it anymore.
Ooh. That's right, he gives me an invisibility potion. That's nice.
Take this and hold on to it. I'll be back for it later. I'll pay you good. Don't lose it.
What?
No time to talk. Snitch or double-cross me and I'll kill you. I mean it.
Okay. What did he just give me? Iron dagger or torpor? That's worth a decent amount of money. 15 points of stamina damage. Okay. I think this has happened to me before.
This should be good.
What? Oh, yeah. Here he comes.
Did you see someone run past just now?
Do I lie and say I didn't see anyone, or do I say, yeah, he went that way?
Great. Thanks. Bastard stole from me. I'll catch him, though.
Go get him. I got your dagger, but you don't know that. Maybe that guy's got other stuff I can take.
You won't leave Skyrim alive.
Did he get him? I'm afraid to go running out into the forest with bears and stuff. Yeah, he got him. Let's go see what that guy had. Poor guy. He had nothing good. Well, we got a lockpick. Take that. Yeah, sorry, pal. Dagger's mine. Well, I made it back here to Shorestone, getting ready to head down to Darkwater Crossing to deliver the parcel for the person that I met here the other night. This could be a dangerous trip. I don't remember for sure what's out in this area, but there's a possibility there could be bears and saber cats, so I'll have to keep my eyes peeled. I don't really know for sure what I'm going to run into out here. Either way, though, this seems like a pretty good spot to wrap things up for this episode, so I think that's what I'm going to do. Appreciate you guys watching, and I hope you'll stick around for the next one.